A gate reduces the volume of the input signal while it is below a specific threshold. But when it rises above this, the gate opens, allowing the original audio to be heard at its full volume. For example, this can be used to silence a constant low noise floor, or to reduce the low volume parts of a complex waveform, such as drum loops. The threshold sets the minimum decibel level at which the input signal will open the gate. Once open, the output volume will begin to ramp upwards, and the attack parameter is the amount of time it takes to reach the normal level. If the gate is open and the signal volume falls back under the threshold, the hold parameter determines how long the gate will be held open, delaying the release phase. Release is the amount of time it takes for the gate to fully close again after the signal falls below the threshold. So, longer release times will result in slower fade-outs. The decibel value of the floor parameter is the amount of volume reduction applied to the gated audio. Setting this to the minimum value will silence it completely. The high and low pass sliders control the frequency range of a filter that's applied to the input. And you can click on the envelope input button to listen to what effect that has. But it's really important to keep in mind that the output audio will not be affected by the filter. The point of this filtering option is just to allow a specific range of frequencies to control the gating of the whole signal. This device also has an alternative duck mode, which reverses the behaviour of the gate, applying the floor value to the audio while it is above the threshold. Note that although this is similar to how a compressor works, there is an important difference here. A compressor will only reduce the part of the waveform that breaches the threshold. While a gate in duck mode will reduce the entire waveform. And finally, the mono stereo option toggles whether a stereo input will gate each of the left and right channels on an individual basis, or if they will be mono mixed, and then that combined signal will be used to gate both channels equally. The env input button can be used to listen in on the mono version of the input, and as with the filter, this is purely for controlling the behaviour of the gate and does not change the stereo nature of the output.